Alberto Carvalho has been running the nation's fourth largest school district since 2008. During that time, he's been named National Superintendent of the Year and State Superintendent of the Year. Students in the district come from 160 countries around the globe and speak 56 different languages. And they've made great progress. Graduation rates are up sharply in the past decade, 58% in the school year ending 2007, jumping to over 80% last year.
From the very first job I had in this country, in the back kitchens of New York, scrubbing pots and pans, then being promoted to being a busboy, working the kitchens as a prep cook, as a day laborer, as a construction worker, to becoming a teacher and now a superintendent, I can tell you that the winds of change, the power that reigns over all Americans, born here or not, those who are here by choice or by chance, must be a promise that's delivered to every child in America today.
It is with great pleasure that I congratulate Miami-Dade Superintendent Alberto Carvalho for being selected as the 2018 recipient of the Green Garner Award presented by the Council of Great City Schools. On behalf of my colleagues on the school board, congratulations, Mr. Carvalho, on this wonderful and well-deserved honor.
Here's what I believe. In the hyper-connected society as we know it today, the digitally disconnected is initially at an educational disadvantage, over time, an economic deficit. Limiting learning and instruction and education to the bell scheduling school was not sufficient.
Hi, my name is Terrence Nickerson. I was once a homeless student back in high school during my senior year, and now I'm a third year in FIU. It's thanks to you, Alberto Carvalho, that I was able to make a better change in my life and get to things I normally couldn't do by myself. It's thanks to you that I have a better opportunity and I'm able to foresee a future that I want for myself. I'm proud to tell you congratulations for being awarded the Green Garner Award, and I'm proud to be here to give you this speech. You are a mentor to me, a father to me, and a very close friend to me. Thank you again for all that you've done for all of us. Congratulations.
My name is Molly Winters Diallo, and I'm the 2019 Miami-Dade County Public Schools Teacher of the Year. I would like to congratulate Superintendent Carvalho. You're a true inspiration to me and my colleagues across the county. Thank you so much for everything that you're doing to advocate for all of us and for education in our county.
Alberto, thank you for always fighting to ensure that the quality of education that our kids receive are not dictated by a zip code or a neighborhood. We are so proud of you in Miami, and congratulations on this very distinguished honor of receiving the Green Garner Award. Now the whole world knows what we know here. You are the best superintendent in the nation. Congratulations.
Alberto, my friend, congratulations on this amazing award. Has been a long time coming, well-deserved, obviously. You continue to be the gold standard as it pertains to our leadership here in our community, as it pertains to our public school system. Keep up the great work, man. I'm always here for you. Love you, brother.
It is fitting that this recognition comes just as you celebrate 10 years as superintendent of Miami-Dade County Public Schools. This award speaks to the commitment that you have shown to our county, always working hard to ensure all students in Miami-Dade receive a great education and graduate with a world of opportunities ahead of them.
Congratulations, my friend. It's good to know that the people around the world know how great you are. I'm glad once again to say to you, keep the good work up, continue to do the best for the world. I love you very much.
There is no secret sauce to transforming communities, to transforming society, and certainly to transforming a public education system. In fact, I believe that all that we need to know to improve education in America, we already know it. So it's no longer a question of a skill deficit, it's a will set proposition. Is do people have the courage to actually do what's right for kids? I am the eternal optimist. I actually see tomorrow as a better reality than the one we live today.